probably asking yourself, how do we get to this oh shit moment? Well, to understand that, you need to understand a little bit about me in the past. And I didn't grow up in a broken home or have a rough childhood. In fact, it was quite the opposite. My father was a lifetime police officer and was the former Vinewood police chief. And my mother, bless her soul, still the CFO of Mays Bank. Now I mention this so that you understand that my life in crime is a choice that I willingly made. Not because I needed the money, because I do not, but more on that later. More so because I had a near-death experience and it opened my eyes to my own possibilities. So now I complete odd jobs that get listed on a backdoor site found on the web. I found that on a guy passed out in the bathroom at the local nightclub. Okay, he wasn't passed out. I drugged him after overhearing a very promising phone call he had. One thing led to another, and now I'm in the biggest pickle of my life, 20s. I took a job that was labeled high risk, high reward, but I probably should have read the fine print. Seemed pretty cut and dry, 13 cars modified to the required specs and earned a cool $31 million. Oh, and I have 31 days and 13 hours to complete the job. I should have known something was up by the numbers, but in hindsight, it is what it is. This is where the devil's in the details. You see, in literally small print, it stated that capture or failure to complete on time would lead to the forfeiture of life. That's why proofreading is key, folks. Oh yeah, and if I decide to quit the job, you guessed it, for fucking forfeiture of my life. Since I now enjoy my life, I plan on keeping it a little while longer. I never cared who a job was for prior to this contract, especially since most contracts involved asset recovery or delivery, at least those I accepted. Never was much for killing, but I love to drive, so for the last 2 years, that's what I've been doing. Which brings us to the 13 cars in question. The list of cars itself was rather odd, but hey, who am I to judge? I figured it's just gonna pay me $31 million. Who fuck cares why? What cars? But I digress. The cars included a Coquette, a Bullet, Comet, a Weezer News Van, an LS Police Cruiser, Turismo R, an Exemplar, a Gauntlet, a Buccaneer, Sentinel XS, a Sultan, an F620, and to top it all off, fucking dump truck. No idea why a dump truck, but yeah, the 13th vehicle is a dump truck. Thankfully, my father thought to teach me how to survive in this world. I learned how to punch people in the face and shoot them in the balls if I had to. My mother, on the other hand, taught me how to live in this world. I know how to sew my own buttons back on and how to cook myself some food. Both of the lessons have kept me alive this far. So here's to them.
Now look, son, the world is ugly.
Yeah, no no lie there.
I'm serious, B. Look, I might not always be around to protect you, but starting tomorrow, you learn how to protect yourself.
What? What do you mean?
Tomorrow you start martial arts classes with Sensei Wu.
Do I have to?
Yeah, or do you like getting hit in the face, as your black eyes suggest?
Okay, Pops, I'll do it.
Good morning. Now back to what I was saying before. Dump truck aside, it should have been a simple job. It would turn out to be anything but simple, which you'll see for yourself soon enough. Okay, remember when I said I didn't need the money? Well, here's why. My father died in the line of duty, but due to the fault of the police department. Long story short, Internal Affairs was investigating an officer in my father's precinct and failed to notify him, which led to my father's death at the hands of said corrupt cop. Now, the city paid millions to keep it from going the distance in court. I mean, of course, they looked bad already, but they didn't want everything else coming out. Hence why I didn't need the money, also why the LSPD hates my guts. Which also brings us to the aforementioned near-death experience. One night, 2 years ago, on the eve of my father's death's anniversary, I get pulled over. Me being raised to respect the law, I pulled over on the side of the road thinking the taillight must have gone out. Instead, the officers yanked me out, threw me on the ground, and cuffed me. My crime was being the son of a good man. You see, my father's untimely death started a domino effect. He had been keeping files on corruption inside the city, not just his department, for years. Those files were set to be released from a secure server in the event he failed to log in for 48 hours. Funny how death would change all sorts of plans. Now, after the fallout from all of that, the ones that escaped jail time or lost their jobs were out for revenge. Since my father was now dead, I was the lucky runner-up. After being placed in the back of their cruiser, I was driven to the dam and dropped over the side. Luck again was on my side. A tree branch that had lodged itself in between some rocks and concrete stopped my fall. It also broke 3 ribs and knocked me out. My relationship with that branch was like all my other relationships. They hurt at first, but make me a better man afterwards. Unlike my other relationships, it hurt quicker, made me a better man faster. It took me roughly 18 hours to get out of that tree and off that dam. Then it took me another 2 hours to walk back to find help. Someone found me. Luckily, they hated the police, so instead of turning me in, they took me home, got me out of those cuffs, fed me, gave me some clothes, and nursed me back to health. She was a lovely woman by the name of Maud, and I do bounties for her every now and then still. But she's also what introduced me to everything else that I'm currently into, which is a lot of shit. All a specific bounty did lead me to the vanilla unicorn, which in turn led me to the knocked out man in the bathroom. So I do not blame Maud, but let's face it, she's not innocent in all this, that's for damn sure. Now I went to the vanilla unicorn to capture a bounty target, which just happened to also be a stripper. The stripper's boyfriend just also happens to be the man I overheard the conversation with and proceeded to knock out in the bathroom. So I captured both my bounty and that man, went back to Maud, told her everything had happened, and instead of telling me not to delve deeper into the dark web, she introduced me to a man named Lester. Now Lester was a very unique, to say the least, individual who introduced me to everything else underneath the sun, from running guns to robbing casinos to sticking up banks and everything in between. It's the network that started everything from there.
Hello, talk to me.
AB Wagwan.
Sup, Reggie? What you got?
The cars you ask about.
What about them? Have you seen one?
Yeah, brother. I seen Bullet del Perro Pia. Parking lot. Can't miss it.
Thanks, Reg. Owe you one.
One love, bro.
After that lovely phone call from Reggie, I decided to go home and eat. And after eating and taking a short nap, decided might as well go and start on this list. And since it was such a nice day outside, I decided why not ride the bike. I have one, I live close enough, let's go. Besides, what better way to get to see the sights and sounds of Los Santos than taking a bike ride down the pier? Or to the pier. Hey, Uncle Jake. Sometimes, folks, you just gotta stop and enjoy the music. Now, it didn't take me long to locate the vehicle in question, one vapid Bullet in all of its glory. Nothing quite says overcompensating for the nether regions like a vapid Bullet. Electronic key cards, gotta love them. Makes it so much easier still, way more easier than you think. Fuck me, knew I heard a chopper. Cops are already on me? Oh, Reggie, you're gonna have some explaining to do. Oh, yes, indeedy. Let's just go ahead and pull over here. Wait him out. Okay, so that didn't work the way I wanted it to. 15 minutes in the tunnel just led to more cops and rain falling. So how about we just turn on some music and enjoy the drive? How about that? I don't know about you, but that gave me goosebumps. What good timing. Oh shit, I'm sure they can buff that out. These guys sure are trying to get their money worth today, that's for certain. Gotta admit, police chase and weather aside, it's a nice day for a drive. You know that feeling you get when things are going too smoothly? And then bam, the universe reminds you what it's really like. Like really, really reminds you what it's like? But it's fine, but if you know one thing about Los Santos, police here can't drive for shit. Whew, nailed it. Got away from them guys just fine. Let's turn this bad boy up.
Oh my god.
When the East is in the house.
Oh my god.
When the East is in the house.
Oh my god.
Ah, the Comet. I actually own one of these myself. And with the smoothest things are going, I figured it'd be best for me to grab as many cars off the list as I could before anyone caught wind of what I was up to or how much money was at stake. Now, it doesn't happen too often. At times, a contract can be given to multiple recipients. And sometimes amendments can be made to said contracts. And sometimes, LSPD's Internet Crimes Division actually does their job and gets it right. They catch wind of the contract and then you have to contend with them as well. Cops aren't even usually the issue. Normally the issue is when another contractor takes said contract and then competes against you. There's no rules, so of course, whoever gets the contract in first gets the payout. And oftentimes, the other one just gets the stress of not getting paid. But give me a second to lose these pesky cops and I'll explain a little bit more to you. I need a little bit of music. As if that's gonna happen. Okay, did I also mention sometimes I do a bit too much? I'm a little too extra. I think I've learned where stormtroopers actually originated.
This is one of those feel-good songs as you believe in nothing in life could possibly go wrong, like anyone standing right in your way as you're driving down an alley. Close one, guy. Close one. Now, of course, he's not hurt, but I'm going to have to pay for that mirror to be replaced. Well, alright, I only took an extra lock around the block to lose the cops. Let's get this bad boy modified and fixed up. And now I'm driving a shiny new dildo. Gimme. Who asked for these mods? Back to what I was saying before, other contractors are actually a bigger threat to the job than, say, the police and or yourself. Sometimes time, but as long as you're a decent time manager, you'll be fine. Where's the live line, kids? Where's the live line? I'd say two cars down off the list isn't too bad in the first day. Then again, I do like the toot my own horn. Metaphors and cliches aside, I have to say that the thing I've learned in life is that, well, life is shitty. All you can do is make the best out of it because you can. Learn how to do that, everything else tends to fall into place, regardless of your chosen career path. Another thing to note is the strange delivery locations for these vehicles. Most of them go to the same place, but some of them are sporadically spread out across the cities where they need to be delivered. Adds a little bit of challenge that I hadn't anticipated when I had taken the job. If you're wondering why I'm not slowing down and obeying the traffic laws, because at this point I just want to get this job over with and done as quickly as possible. I need the money. I'm just kidding. I really don't need the money. It's just fun. I like driving. Besides, I look for every chance I can to stick it to LSPD. It's the least I can do for my father. Oh boy, I'm getting sleepy. I'll have to do something about that. Let's get this party started. Just a little on that turn. In my defense, I did say I was tired, and I've already ran into a couple things, so I'm slightly sore.
Good find, man.
Thanks, I really do what I can. One of the snazzy perks to membership of the Criminal Underground is a car delivery service. Can't beat that. With it being late and the docks being virtually empty, I decided to hone my skills and practice while I'm here. I mean, you saw that crap from before. Come on, practice wouldn't hurt anyone. Besides, it gives us a chance to chat for you to get to know me a little bit better before you decide if I'm a piece of shit or not. It may not seem like it, but I do live by a code. Don't endanger women and children, I don't involve them, and I do my best not to kill anyone that doesn't deserve it. But I'm not gonna lie and say that things haven't happened, because hey, it's life and shit happens. If you lived in Los Santos, you'd understand my disdain for the police as well. Not to mention the horrible drivers here, like seriously, horrible. Anywho, I like to say I'm like Batman, but kinda, wait, is that, that's it. Dump truck, it's on the list. You may have noticed the tinge of excitement in my voice, but what can I say? It's not often that things go this smoothly, this quickly. Hardworking man, thrown from truck, I know, shit move, but hey, like I said, sometimes shit happens. Don't mind that, that's just my phone letting me know I have a message from my girlfriend, Sharon, who I gotta go see later. She may be upset with me, and she may have a reason to be upset with me, but overall, I'd have to say, today was a good day.
Yeah. Waking up in the morning, gotta thank God. I don't know, but today seems kinda high. No barking from the dog, no small. And mama cooked the breakfast with no hog.
All right, let's keep right there. We're gonna have to disagree. I like my bacon and sausage. I gotta go, cause I got me a drop top. If I hit the switch, I can make the ass drop. I'm the only jacker in sight. Got a message from Siobhan, she's mad cause I was out all night.
Called up the homies and I'm asking y'all, which part are y'all playing basketball? Get me on the court and I'm troubled. Last week messed around and got a triple double. Freaking brothers everywhere like MJ. I can't believe
today. 3 down, 10 to go. Not too shabby. After a longer than intended nap on a very uncomfortable couch, Grumpy Gary woke me up and I'm back at it again. Gotta get the gas and snacks though. There's a twofold reason why I'm here. See, this is also a location where you can normally find some of the more expensive cars as people drive up the coast. And they have some really good donuts for a convenience store.
Let me know if you need anything.
I'm good, buddy. Thanks. It's gonna grab me a Sprunk. Oh shit, it's out of order. Guess I'll get me a cola.
Stand by for Channel 7 News special update. Hal Hinkleman here, Channel 7 News. The LSPD is looking for a man in conjunction with a series of grand theft auto.
Please don't describe me. Please don't describe me.
200 pounds and having great dreads.
Anyone? Yep, shit, they just described me. Well, gonna have to change up some things because they're all looking at me. I'm sorry, did I bump you? Would you rather I take my hands and put them around your head and squeeze? No? Where are you going? Where are you going? Thought you saw something you liked, none you want to say no. Hey! Hey, really? You running? Thank God he ran. I really didn't want to punch that guy in the face. He seemed like a nice guy. Alright, next. Lady, I broke you because you're standing too close to the donuts. Move your ass. And next time, leave room for other people to get to the donut. I know I shouldn't. It's so fun messing with people. Like this poor schlob. He has no idea what's going to happen next. None. Alright, my friend. Where were we? First of all, turn off the fucking music. Second, give me the money.
Okay, I'm trying.
Also, give me your car keys and your ride. You probably think this is just another dick move in a long line of dick moves, but that's where you'd be wrong. This is actually to distract from my main goal. See, these poor bastards heard the description on the radio, so I need to distract them. Away from what I'm really up here for. No need to kill this man, he's just doing his job. The real reason I'm up here is because I got a lead on a new car that's been added to the list. Oh yeah. Forgot to mention the list got changed. I received an email. Three of the vehicles are no longer the same. That being said, I'm on my way up here now to rob some joker who lives in a nice house of his really nice car. Can't wait. It's not every day you get to steal a grotty Italy RSX. While the police investigate the robbery of the convenience store by the suspect matching the description, I'll quietly make my way up to this house and get the car that I'm searching for. This shit right here is what I mean by the really bad drivers. Just swerves in my lane to act like nothing happened. Oh, there's the police. Shit, are you looking for me? Yep, definitely looking for me. Well, this is gonna make it a little more difficult than... Hey, how you doing? That's a nice ride you got there. Don't mind me, Sharon wouldn't mind. She admires beauty where she sees it as well. I mean, I know she doesn't know me, but that doesn't mean that I can't appreciate that she looks very nice. the fact that the police are still behind me. Maybe I need to focus. How on earth did they know where to look for me? Were they tipped off already this soon? It hasn't even been that long. Oh shit, Reggie. Oh shit, I wonder if Reggie's talked to anyone. I'm gonna have to call him. I knew things were going too smoothly, but hey, I tried to be an optimist. Oh, coming up on the house now. It's almost go time. I'm far enough ahead of the police now, I should have plenty of time to get in this car and get out of here. Car literally says Joker on the license plate. Wasn't expecting that. But hey, it was being used in a movie. Not sure what they were filming. Something about assisted death group or something like that. Bunch of convicts hired to do jobs the government can't take care of. With them being in the middle of filming, I'm pretty sure they're not going to like the fact that I stole this car. But hey, $34 million is on the line. They're gonna feel bad in the morning, but hey, don't let them get up. Ooh, look at that, they're using their manners. Time to get in the zone and get this bad boy taken care of and delivered. So, that being said, let's move the time for this. The addition of the helicopter is a nice touch, boys, but you don't know much about this engine, do you? This engine purrs. A little off-roading, can avoid the roadblock. These guys are literally gunning for me. Don't mind the blood on my hands, just from the window shattering from the gunshots. Oh, damn it. I think I'm actually going the wrong way. I am. Son of a bitch. I'll have to turn around and go back. I'm back in LSPD territory. Probably not the smartest idea while the sheriffs are still behind me, but hey, I gotta do what I gotta do. I know, almost hit that car, but it was so worth it. I needed to light this J. Judge me all you want, but it calms my nerves, enables me to do better. I'll take it. Besides, I'm already breaking the law. What's the little joint gonna do? I'm honestly surprised that a vehicle that was being used in the filming of a motion picture was included on this list. In Los Santos, those things are normally off the list. For whatever reason, the motion picture studios here have it in with the criminals and they get left alone. Again, not saying that they're not caught in the crossfire, we just tend to usually leave them alone and they leave us alone. There's no need for name calling, I can still hear you. I literally can drive circles around these guys. Sit back and enjoy the ride. We'll be there in no time, I'm sure. I try not to stereotype, but as you can clearly see from the accident, some stereotypes may just fit. Usually the tunnel is pretty packed. I'm surprised I have this much space to maneuver. Again, things are working smoothly in my favor. Now should be a good time to car edge. There's enough space between me and the police. Cops are all over my ass, and I need to get this job done. I need this money. You know I don't, but you know what I'm saying. It's 31 million, bro. Call me back. Okay, I'm usually not worried, but Reggie always answers his phone no matter what he's doing. And I swear, no matter what he's doing, on the toilet, in a woman, it doesn't matter. He always answers. He's a businessman. He's not answering. It's got me nervous. On the plus side, I've lost the cops, and now I can drive at a normal rate. Hopefully. With Sharon at work, I guess I'll have to call up one of my boys and see if I can get some help with this job. I'm obviously in a little bit over my head. Won't hurt me none to call in some backup. And for $31 million, I'm sure I can afford whatever it is that they ask. Oh, I hope you didn't think my boys would do it for free. It's not how we roll. And I'm not mad at them for it. We all gotta get paid. Figure I'll hit them up in the morning, let them know what's going on, and see where we can go from there. I'm gonna need some sleep after tonight. After some much needed rest in the evening at home with Sharon, whom you'll get to meet later, don't worry, I decided it'd be a good idea to take the convertible out. Then it started raining, and I've been sitting here for the last 20 minutes trying to decide what I'm going to do next. You may be asking yourself, why not just change out your vehicle? Well, the problem is I stole this one as to not drive one of my own personal vehicles while I'm out and about. Gotta be smarter than your average bear, Yogi. God, I love this fucking city. Even when it rains, it's still beautiful. Well, let's get to it then. As far as I know, a little rain's never killed anyone. But I could be wrong. It's been known to happen. Since the Italy RSX replaced the Gauntlet, Revolter replaced the Buccaneer. It's the only two vehicles that have been swapped out on the list. I got a lead on the Revolter being at the Diamond Casino and Resort, so hopefully it's there when I get there. Nobody's seen or heard from Reggie in the last 2 days after I got my last phone call from him, so hopefully he's okay. But I was able to get a hold of my boys Dan and Grizzly. They're on their way to the city to help me out. Dan was visiting his family back in the UK, and Grizzly was up north in the Toledo Bay area completing contracts. Both of them gladly decided to help me after I offered each of them $10 million. Again, I told you I don't do it for the money. Guess you could say I'm an action junkie of sorts. Saw the Revolter in the parking lot as I was pulling in, but I need a distraction, and luckily this guy's gonna provide it. And since the police already know what I look like, there's no point in worrying about these guys taking photos. So instead, while they're focused on everything going to shit, I'm gonna go get this car. Beautiful red one right over there. Also, with the people scattering everywhere, it'll give the police something else to focus on while I grab the car. Nothing they hate more than people running and them not knowing why. It was at this moment that I had this weird feeling in my gut, like something just wasn't right. And I probably should have stuck with it, but I didn't. I was thinking about the money. Ominous music usually precedes a tragic event. And only time will tell how tragic this event really is. Yes, folks, that's C4 right there attached to that car that I'm about to walk up on. And I'm sure you're wondering, if the car blew up, where was I? This life has taught me anything, that sometimes things aren't always what they seem. Sometimes you gotta go to drastic measures to achieve your goals. And other times, life just smashes you in the face and reminds you, you're its little bitch. I'm sure you have all kinds of questions that you're looking for answers. I have no problem giving those answers. And I'm sure Din, Grizzly, and Sharon are going to be pissed at me about this. But hey, can't control everything. Clearly I survived because I'm able to tell you the story. But how I survived? Well, that, my friends, I will gladly explain to you next time.